I think we can start with the session. I'm going to give a session today about advanced ROI-driven internet marketing strategies. So a broad view on the possibilities for within different channels in the field of internet marketing with focus on ROI as a goal. That means that I believe in ROI is king when you use the internet. The power of the internet is in measuring everything. And when you know what your ROI is, you can use different channels and you can scale it up. So the trick is not to only use AdWords, because AdWords is just one channel, but you should look to other channels and scale things up. So I'll give a broad view on several possibilities to scale that up and to maximize your ROI today. Okay, my name is Joris Toenders. I started with internet marketing 10 years ago when I was a little guy. And I didn't play football. I just was interested in the internet and entrepreneurship. So I'm from an entrepreneurial family, and I saw the possibility to sell ringtones. Probably many of you have bought ringtones in the past. Many of you know the companies like Jamster, who are selling ringtones on a subscription basis. And I thought, okay, let's sell the ringtones on a ons basis. So just people can just order ringtones and pay $2 for it, and then they come back when they want another ringtone. But I didn't have the money, so I was 15 years old when I started. And I did, I almost had maybe $100. So I thought, okay, let's take a look how I can get traffic, how I can get conversions, and generate return on investment without spending money. So that's a big challenge. And I started reading some books, reading a lot of SEO books, internet marketing books. And I started playing with Google, started playing with my website. Just did some tricks in the code of my website. And after 1 year, I was at school. I remember that day. And I was on a lesson and was behind my computer. And I typed in ringtones in Google. And I saw that my website was on number one in the organic positions. So that was a very good day. You may understand. And so what better was when I was looking at the statistics, I saw thousands of visitors on a daily basis. I think almost 500,000, 600,000 unique visitors per month. So I started selling thousands of ringtones, and I saw the power of search engine optimization. But after that, I was 2 years further, and I saw my days. I was spending a lot of time on answering questions for customers. They asked me, how can I install that ringtone? And I didn't like that, because my passion was in internet marketing. My passion was SEO. My passion was return on investment. My passion was find creative ways to earn a lot of money via internet and not spending a lot. So that's was the beginning of Yonego nowadays, and thought a lot. Okay, what should I do? And I didn't have had a lot with ringtones. I didn't have a big passion for ringtones. My passion was internet marketing and entrepreneurship. So I thought, okay, what should be the case when I'm going to help other companies to generate return on investment via internet and pay me for the results. Pay me based on the number of conversions, pay me for the amount of money I'm going to generate for them. And that's what I'm doing today with almost 40 colleagues in the Netherlands and Belgium. As you may hear, I'm speaking English like you guys are speaking Dutch. But I love it, and I'm working on my passion every day. I love entrepreneurship. I love to set up a company, to set up a culture, a company culture, to work on the results of clients and to find creative ways to maximize return on investment. When you start looking at generating ROI via internet marketing, everything starts with measuring. That sounds like an open door. I think most people of you will know that when you are at the affiliate summit, because affiliate marketing is also about tracking results. Otherwise, you will earn nothing. So when you start, you just should use Google Analytics and take a look. Why are people leaving? Where are they leaving? What are they buying? Because when you know that, you can test it out and optimize things. Optimize the process to maximize conversion rates and return on investment. And then you're really curious about, okay, what's my conversion rate? What's my average order value? How good is my website? So you need to generate relevant traffic. And in most cases, it's not easy to generate relevant traffic when you set up a new website. Simply because you have a lot of competitors. There are millions of websites. You've earned no money with the website. So you should test with Google AdWords and check out your conversion rates and average order value. I advise it to my clients because when you send 1,000 visitors, for example, from keywords which are relevant to what you are selling, you can check out, okay, how where can I optimize? And that's the basis of scaling things up. A good way to do that is to use the $50 of Google. Many of you will know that coupon. And that's a good way to just send 1,000 relevant visitors and roll out to other channels after that, when the KPIs are good. And then you check out the impact of several KPIs. Because when your conversion rate is 1%, for example, and your average order value is $10, it's easy to know that one visitor will is worth around 10 cents. So you should look, okay, how to scale things up for 10 cents. You need to pay less than 10 cents when you use Google AdWords, for example, or Facebook ads to generate a positive ROI. And in most cases, you will see that when you launch your website, your conversion rates are not as good as you thought before you start. Because you think, you start, you made a business case, and you think, okay, my conversion rates will be 5% or 10%, but that will not be the case in most cases. So when your conversion rate is not good enough to generate a positive ROI, you start with A/B testing, multivariate testing. Hopefully many of you know what that is, but I can give an example. In this case, you see that the original page has a conversion rate of 10%. When you start testing with buttons, for example, or text on the page, images, call to actions, etc., you will see that when you test combinations via, for example, the Google Website Optimizer or the Visual Website Optimizer, you can maximize your the rates. And when the rates are better, become better, you will improve your ROI directly, instantly. And that creates a way that is the beginning to scale up to other channels. There are some great tools for it. I will give you some more tools during this session. For example, you have the Visual Website Optimizer, you have BT Buckets and Clicktail, Campal and Mopinion. And that are some tools which you can use to analyze quantitative data and qualitative data, just to get feedback. Okay, what do people like within your website? But also, where are they leaving and why are they leaving? What kind of feedback are they giving? Your visitors are the boss, so data is king. And there are some really easy, quick wins within conversion optimization. These are some of them. You test different offers. That sounds like quite easy, but when you test different offers, for example, free shipping, that will improve your ROI directly when you test a lot. If you see that you're using free shipping, for example, and your average order value, your average margin is $10, and shipping will cost you $2, your conversion rate after testing that improves probably with 30%, then you directly earn it back within your margin. So it didn't cost you anything. You will directly earn it back. So test free shipping. When you test free shipping, it can be the case that you improve your ROI and your conversion rate directly and you earn it instant back. Site search is a great way. Okay, what are people searching for within your website? I see in many cases that of web shops with my clients that people are searching for an iPad, but the web shop isn't offering an iPad. When you don't offer an iPad and thousands of people are searching for an iPad, okay, it's logical that you won't convert. So that's really good information to use as a basis to check out, okay, which products I'm going to sell. Use that information to buy new products, to add new products to your website, and that will improve. Use reviews. Don't be angry to use reviews on your website. People are looking for reviews. If you don't use reviews on your own website, people are looking on other websites for their reviews. So it's better that they see negative reviews on your own website than they see it on a comparison site. Simply because when they are on a competitor site, they will see your own competitors. A good example of conversion optimization is Booking.com. That is a great website, a hotel booking website, a great website which really understands the tactics of optimizing conversion rates. If I'm browsing the website, I'm looking for a hotel. I was looking for a hotel in New York. I found the Hilton. When you're looking for a hotel there, you see 10 people are looking to this hotel right now. And behind that, you see the number of rooms available. You can understand that when you see that there are 10 people browsing directly right now on that hotel page, and there are only 2 rooms available, people are likely to buy. Because they think, okay, maybe otherwise another one, other people will buy. Show visitors how many products you still have in stock. That works pretty good. When I am in the city and you're shopping and you see 2 jeans within your size, you're more likely to buy the jeans directly than you see 20 jeans in your size. That's pretty easy, conversion optimization. And do the registration after you have the sale. Many web shops are this doing wrong because they are using registration before you've paid. And you will lose orders directly. If I'm browsing and I want a new iPad and I'm searching for iPad in Google and I come within a website and I want to buy the iPad, but I need to fill in my address, my name, my phone number, my postal code, etc. I don't want that. I just want to buy and I don't need to create an account. Just after I've made this, I've done the sale, so I've bought the item, then give me the option to register. So maybe you can influence people by giving them a discount when they register on their next order. Then you work also directly on retention. And when you have a positive ROI, then the party can begin. This is what I really like. Maybe you guys know the toppers. The toppers are really cool in the Netherlands. There's like three gay guys, which are singing a lot. And so they are making a great party in the Netherlands. And in internet marketing, the party really can start when you have a positive ROI on one or two channels. You see increasing conversion rates. You are testing already. You are measuring conversion rates. Because then you can scale things up. I love this quote. I see it, I saw it on, I taught a few years ago on an affiliate summit conference for the first time. People don't read advertising. They read what interests them, and sometimes that is advertising. This is really important to remember when you are using advertising for your brand. Because people don't always like to when advertising is coming on their face. They want relevant advertising. Advertising which is relevant to what they are searching for. That is why Google is so successful as it is today. And Groupon is losing thousands of members, millions of members, just because they are sending me offers on a daily basis, which I'm not interested in. I want to use specific, get specific offers based on what I'm interested in, based on my intent. When you're using AdWords, it's quite important to check out, okay, what queries are people searching for. When you just look to the keywords, when you just see, okay, I want to use the keyword vacation, for example. People are also using for vacation books, vacation to France, vacation to Italy, etc. So when you need to analyze the intent of that people, you should use the query reports. You have query reports in Google Analytics and also in Google AdWords. And there you can take a look, okay, how can I optimize conversion rates based on the intent of my visitors? And find new magnets with site search. Thousands of people are probably searching within your website. I guess that many of you have no idea what they are searching for within your website. I said it earlier, if they are searching for an iPad, but you don't offer an iPad, you will not convert. So, that's a really easy way to maximize your conversion. Check Wikipedia article traffic statistics. This is a really cool tool, really easy, but it's a great inspiration to check out new keyword magnets. To check out, okay, what kind of keywords are people searching for and which can I use for my campaigns. If you see that Wikipedia is ranking on the top on an organic keyword, you probably want to know, okay, what kind of traffic is coming from that keyword. You can use tools for that, some Google tools, of course. But you also can use, for example, this tool. And that's a great inspiration for me and my team to use as keyword analysis. I haven't seen this much times, but I see some advertisements, advertisers are using this. When you are advertising on other keywords, for example, ringtones, but people are using a Z for that, or just spelling it wrong, use "did you mean" in your advertisements. People are know the "did you mean." So when you use that, just use it in your AdWords advertisement. Just use it in your text, "did you mean ringtones," and spell it right. I'm sure that you will see, you will be happy with the CTR of that, and hopefully with the ROI. But that depends on your conversion. Optimize text based on the ROI per 1,000 views. In I think 99% of all AdWords accounts, people are optimizing their text based on the CTR. Is CTR your goal? Hopefully not. Hopefully ROI is your goal, or brand awareness, or something like that. So optimize based on the goal. Optimize based on ROI. Optimize on the ROI per 1,000 views in Google. When your average order value per conversion is, for example, in this case, $22, and your CTR of one advertisement is 10%, and your conversion rate is 1%, you have 80,000 impressions, and you're spending $800 on it, and you have another advertisement with a 5% CTR and a 3% conversion, and 80,000 impressions also, and you're spending also $800 on that advertisement, you will see that if you look what brings you more, brings you a better ROI per 1,000 views, that's advertisement too. But it's really important. Analyze your AdWords accounts based on this metric. This is a really good metric to analyze the quality and the results of your advertisements. Many of you, I'm sure, are losing thousands of dollars because people are using CTR as a target. So there's a big opportunity in here. Use advanced search in your site links. When people are searching for booking.com or Hotels London, for example, they want advanced search. They want to take a look, okay, I want to spend $50 on it, I want to spend $100 on it, I want to be there for 5 nights or for 10 nights, or I want a swimming pool, or using Wi-Fi. So people are looking for advanced search. Use that within your site links, or use that within your title. So you give people the opportunity, the possibility to search on hotels based on your own specifics, based on your own wishes. How can you get the attention of a visitor? The best way to analyze this is to use tools like Clicktail, for example. Clicktail is a great tool to analyze, okay, why are people leaving, where are they leaving, why don't they fill in the form correctly, what are they filling in. But before you launch your website, it's great to look, okay, on why are, in this case you can analyze where the eyes of people are going to. It's a great tool. You fill in your website address, and this tool will take a look and show you where the eyes of people are probably going to. It's not the right way to analyze it, but it can give you some inspiration before you launch how you can optimize your website. Change text, for example, in the morning. Probably your audience has another intent when they are searching for relevant keywords in your topic in the morning than they have later during the day. It's great to surprise them with another text. Why don't you say in your advertisements, target for people that are searching in the morning, and say in the text, good morning, or something like that. Or say 50% discount in the morning, during this morning. So you get the attention of that people. Sell your products via Facebook. There's a lot of news going on. A lot of blogs are blogging about it, about F-commerce, Facebook commerce, about the opportunity within Facebook to sell your products. But if you look to 1,000 webshops, for example, most webshops are doing that today. But there's a big opportunity. If you sell your products also via Facebook, people can check out, okay, what are my friends buying? They can browse within Facebook. They are more and more using Facebook as a platform instead of a website. So So sell your products there. Your audience is there, I'm sure, because there are millions of people. It's one of the biggest countries in the world. So sell. Sell it. Sell it there. Sell it where your audience is. Don't look to only to your website, but look to other channels. And advertise with your Facebook page, also in Google. You can optimize your volume when you're advertising with two brands or with two different URLs within Google. That's not allowed when you have two copies of your website, but it's allowed when you have your own website, a normal shop, and when you have a Facebook shop. So when people are searching for shoes and you are selling shoes, you just show in Google, advertise with your shoes webshop, your normal URL, your own website, and your Facebook page. You can generate likes with it, you can sell it via that channel. They are within Facebook, so you have more trust than when they are only on your website and you don't have a brand. AdWords campaign experiments. What will happen when you double your CPC? Or what will happen when you lower your CPC? Or you can test different things. What will happen? It was a big frustration of me personally a year ago that I can't test that. Because I will know, okay, what happens when I double my CPC? Will my conversion rate increase? Will my conversion rate be lower? Will my volume increase? Will my volume double? What will happen? You can test it with campaign experiments. Just use it within your AdWords interface. It's out of beta currently, so it's a great tool. And use it to check it out. Just to do an experiment and test it. Everything you test, that brings you more. Not in all cases it will improve things or it improves your ROI or conversion rate, but it will give you data, and data is always king in online marketing. When you have more data, when you have good data beats opinion. This is a really cool quote of Avinash Kaushik, evangelist of Google. Maximize your ROI or die. Be sure you are on mobile. Almost 12% of all people, of all queries within Google, are queries generated from a mobile device. So there are a lot of advertisers that are spending thousands of dollars advertising on mobile. But they don't have a mobile page. They don't have a mobile checkout. Here's a big opportunity, because when you create a mobile page, when you create a mobile checkout, and you optimize campaigns based on the device, you can optimize things. So be sure you're on mobile. Test it out and check out the opportunity. Use backfeed data to optimize and to maximize your ROI. If you're only looking to gain Google Analytics data, you won't see everything. If you're only looking to Google AdWords data, you won't see everything. If you're only looking to Campile data, you won't see everything. If you look to all that kind of data, and you also use and analyze and look to your backfeed data, you will have a really good view about opportunities and how things are growing or slowing down. So use product feed data, for example. Identify out of stock new and drop products, for example. If you drop a product, if you have a new product, it's really important, of course, that people can find your product via Google. Otherwise, you won't sell a lot. So use that data and use product feed data. Offline data, are you already tracking coupons or phone tracking? The ROI of offline is in many cases much bigger than people are thinking. When you have a shop, or when you have different shops in several cities, I'm sure that when you are communicating the shop via your website, people are also visiting your shop. After that, they were searching via Google. So that's also ROI. That's offline ROI, of course, but that's ROI. That's based on the things you did with AdWords. So analyze that and use coupons, for example, to track it. Conversion value data. Use credit scores for lead validation and knock out canceled orders. That gives you a better view of the really real ROI. Use customer type data, new customers via existing customers. You can use that to have a better view. Simply because maybe a new customer may cost you $10 and an existing customer who comes back via Google may only cost you $5 because you already paid for it. Use customer value data. Do people who bought a cheap product also buy an expensive product? If people are buying clothes for maybe $5 within your website, or really cheap shoes, and you are advertising on that, probably the next time they will buy an expensive product. You need to know that, because that's a big influence on your ROI. So that gives a better view, okay, what kind of keywords, what kind of sourcing, what kind of channels not only are generating conversions, but are also improving my lifetime value. And of course, many of you know this discussion, check out the attribution. If you see that people are coming up again and again and again back within your website, to your website, before they are converting, measure the influence. Measure the influence of the whole buying process. Because the influence of, for example, display advertising, we've seen it in the past year with the coming up of retargeting and lots of tools which makes it easier to analyze attribution credit, are in most cases much bigger than people are thinking. Use it so you can, you don't create a problem when you check out the ROI of display directly and you make the decision to stop with advertising on display, but then you see that the traffic via Google AdWords is going down or via Facebook is going down. Maybe also display advertising will generate likes on Facebook for you, or will generate leads via another channel, or will result in direct visitors. If you're using email marketing, it's also important to analyze and to connect it with your analytics tool, your analytics data. For example, MailChimp is a really great tool. It's a little bit expensive when you're sending a lot of mails, but it's a great tool to target the right people when you have the data. But you need to analyze, okay, what's the ROI of this tool? What's the ROI of this tool versus another tool? What's the ROI of email marketing? When I'm advertising to acquire new email addresses, what's the ROI of an email address? What's the ROI of an email address versus existing channels? What's the ROI of email marketing versus Google AdWords? You can use a really cool tool, MailChimp, which you can connect with Google Analytics, and then you can see the whole package of data. I love it. What is better than spy on your competitors? Many of you are probably thinking, okay, what's the conversion rate of my competitor? What's the marketing campaign of my competitor? Why are they generating so much revenue? Where is that revenue coming from? Why are they advertising? What kind of keywords are they advertising on? What kind of advertisements are they using? tool to you to check this out is Keyword Spy. There are several tools in the market to analyze competitors. But here you can simply check out. It's not always accurate. But you can check it out, okay, what kind of keywords are my competitors advertising on? And it can give you a lot of inspiration for your own campaigns. I said it earlier, Clicktail is an amazing tool. Thousands of businesses are using it every day to optimize the conversion of forms. Forms are, in most cases, very important conversion pages because people are going to buy, people are going to leave their information, etc. So you don't want that people, thousands of people are coming, are visiting your form, are seeing a register form or a buying form or a lead generation form, but they don't fill in the data because they need to fill in their phone number. Maybe lots of visitors don't want to fill out their phone number. So you should analyze that, and you can do that on a really easy basis with Clicktail. You can also watch live videos, which is a very nice inspiration. Take a pizza on the office and check out the live videos of visitors. It can give you a lot of inspiration because you can see where the mouse is going to. You can see how people are browsing through your website. And maybe that gives you another ideas where you can optimize things. Create an alert for four pages. Probably you have a lot of traffic on 404 pages. You have links from other websites to 404 pages. Or maybe you have links to 404 pages within your own website. A great way to analyze this one is to use the alerts within Google Analytics. You simply use this form. It's in Google Analytics. You can find it really easy. And it gives you an alert when you got visitors, for example, on a 404 page. Optimize your margins with visual website optimizer. I take a visual website optimizer in this case, for example. We are working for a long time with them. It's a really great tool. It's not a big company, it's a really small company, but they have built a great technology, which makes it very easy to edit a page, to create a new test on your website, and do that without hiring IT people. In most cases, people are not testing, are not using A/B testing because IT is too busy. And that's really frustrating because lots of opportunity is just in this case. If you optimize your margins, you don't need to just only optimize your conversion rates because your conversion rate can increase. But if you if your margins are slowing down, you're not generating a positive ROI. So optimize your margins with Google Website Optimizer. If you take this one, for example, you see a fixed cost price per sale, per conversion for you as a merchant, of $10. And just set up a test when you use a different price. That's an idea. You can test a button, you can test the color, you can test text. But you can also test your margins, test your price. Is your price high enough? Is your price too low? If people are willing to spend a few more dollars on it, why shouldn't you ask them? So in this case, for example, if you have a fixed cost price per sale of $10 and you ask a price to your visitors of $20, you got 1,000 clicks, 20 conversions. Your total margin is $200. In the second case, you see that when you're asking a price of $30 and you're generating the same amount of clicks, less conversions, 15 conversions, your margin is $300. So, what's better? What do you choose? Hopefully the second one. Because then you're earning more money. Elance. Who of you have problems with IT on a daily basis? Not many. I think there are more people. They don't want to say it, maybe. But most companies have problems with IT departments because they're always too busy. They don't have the time. The systems are difficult. I don't like that. Just look to other ways to get things done. Elance is a marketplace, probably you know it, where thousands of developers, thousands of translators, thousands of other freelancers, but also companies, are replying to jobs. So you can just say, okay, I want to set up a test. I want to get this job done. I want to make a translation. I want to create this tool. Set it on Elance and let people do a bid for it. Let people bid for it. So that makes it quite easier and you are going faster as a marketer. Advertise before products are launched. For example, we did a case several years ago when the first iPhone was launched. We did that for a phone company. And we did a case where we were advertising on iPhone and other relevant keywords to that in Google. We were the own advertiser. That's in the Netherlands, of course. We were the own advertiser, which was advertising on iPhone during several months. We've generated thousands of visitors on a daily basis from people which were searching for iPhone. They were very relevant. And when the iPhone launched, companies were spending their money via Google, were spending thousands of dollars to advertise, to reach people which want to buy the iPhone. But we got already thousands of pre-orders for a really better CPO. They are spending a lot more. And that was the end, so I'm happy to answer questions. I hope you can, you have some interesting questions and I will be glad to answer them. You can use the microphone for it. If there are no questions, hopefully you have a great day. Enjoy Affiliate Summit. Thank you. Thank you.